Hey guys, Josh Culler here, the host of the Good Success Podcast. Hey, I'm just dropping in here to let you know that we are giving a free book away. Yes, a free book called Active Turnkey, The Best Way to Buy Rentals by Tom Olson himself, the president of Good Success. Yes, I did say we are giving it away for free. All you got to do is go to goodsuccess.com/ATK book. Again, that's goodsuccess.com/ATK book. As an active turnkey. And we're gonna cover the book. So we're gonna actually pay for the book and give it to you for free. We're just asking you to cover shipping costs, which is very minimal compared to the value that you're gonna be getting in the book. So if you are interested in learning how to create financial freedom with real estate, go get your copy now. Again, that is goodsuccess.com/ATK book. Thank you for listening to the Good Success Podcast, and I hope you enjoy this episode. Welcome back to the Good Success Podcast. I'm your host, Josh Culler. And today we've got Tom Olson with us. Today it's just going to be me and Tom chatting. Yes. And Tom is going to talk about what is keeping you from financial freedom. So this is a really big topic. We talk about it a lot on the podcast here. One of the chapters in the Active Turnkey book is financial freedom through real estate, the best way to buy rentals, which is Active Turnkey. And so this is something that's batted around a lot and really talked about in the real estate industry. Specifically with passive income. So we're going to talk about that today. But before we get into it, if you guys have not already, make sure you have subscribed to the Good Success Podcast. We're on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Stitcher, Google Play, and all the podcast platforms. Just go to the platform, search Good Success, and you'll be able to find us there. And a little bit of a sneak peek, we're actually going to be having an app rolling out soon with just the podcast. So you guys will be able to download the app there. It's feeding from Libsyn, so we're super excited about that. You won't have to go to any of these other podcast platforms. Just download the app and we're right there.
So be like, click.
It's going to be super.
You can listen to Josh and Tom.
Super easy.
Whenever you want.
Listen to Josh and Tom. That's it. So we'll roll that out. We'll let you guys know when that comes out, but it is coming down the pipe. So just be ready for that. It'll be on the App Store for Apple, for iTunes, and then also for the Google Play Store for Androids. So
The Good Success app.
I'm so excited. Cool. It's going to be great. But you guys be on the lookout for that. We're going to be announcing that pretty soon, so you won't have to subscribe on these other platforms. But also, we have the Active Turnkey book, Best Way to Buy Rentals. So I think, Tom, we got a video out the other day.
I signed this one.
I think you signed all of these. So, yeah. You signed all of these, and then a secret message is in there. But I think we established the other day that the worth of these books with the signed copy is the price. Like, someone will be able to sell this and get a spaceship.
I'm pretty sure that if you get the signed copy, it's going to be worth something.
You're going to be able to buy a spaceship. That's what we established. We even did a whole little video on it and everything. So
I'm sorry. When you say spaceship, I just think of all my kids and all the shows that they've watched. I'm going on a ship on my favorite rocket ship.
I don't know.
Flying that. Through the skies. Kids, so. Little Einsteins.
Maybe just because I have little Einsteins for kids. So I have a nephew and he watches that. I get it. Okay.
You heard it here first. It'll be worth as much as a spaceship.
You'll be able to trade it for a spaceship. Like, that's just the bottom line. But you guys can go pick yours up for free at goodsuccess.com/ATK book.
Emily is laughing at us.
Emily's laughing. She's, man. Hey, it's true, though. I mean, you guys... You don't even know. You're getting it for free.
What else can you... Because if you knew, you would know, and you don't even know.
So. Where else can you get something that you can afford a spaceship with that's for free?
That's right. And we are giving it away for free.
For free.
All you have to do is pay for shipping, and you get my free book.
GoodSuccess.com/ATK book is where you can pick yours up. Make sure you take advantage of that.
And Josh, we just got back the proofread copy.
It's going on Amazon.
Of my newest book that's coming out.
Oh, yes.
Which is how to deal with contractors in this environment. So I'm super excited about that. And eventually, you guys will also have an opportunity to get that book
as well. Absolutely. And big shout out to Carol Ellis for helping us out with that.
Thank you so much.
So, soon to be announcements on that. I'm very excited about it. So it's another project that we got coming down the pipe here. So a lot going down. And then in a couple of weeks, we have the November Mastermind in Miami, Florida, which we're excited about. We have a lot of new attendees that are going to be there. A lot of great action that's going down in Miami. November 8, 9, and 10 is when that's happening. And we do have a boating activity the day before on the 7th, where we're getting everybody from the mastermind onto a boat, just a lot of networking. We had the members ask us for more networking, So we got a boat, we're putting them on it. And special thanks to NREG, National Real Estate Insurance Group, for sponsoring that. But that's what's happening November 8, 9, and 10. The boating activities on the 7th, goodsuccess.com/masterminds, where you can learn more about the mastermind. We got a great group in there. Our four core values are community, stewardship, growth, and charity. And every single person that's in our group encompasses those core values. And that's kind of how we vet people coming in addition to their business and the volume that they're doing and all that. So I keep hitting my watch on the cup. So anyway, again, goodsuccess.com/masterminds, where you can go and check out our mastermind. And I know it's a little close to the November event, but if you fill out your application in time and you come visit us, obviously, if you're listening to this podcast a little bit later on, the next event is going to be in February in Dallas. And right now we're the dates are February 6, 7, and 8, but we might be changing that to a full week here after the November mastermind. So
if you guys are interested, get with us and maybe bug us if you're interested in the November mastermind.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So you can fill out the application there at goodsuccess.com/mastermind, then you'll talk to either myself or Tom, and we'll go from there. And then the community go giver event, we have pre-sale tickets already going on, so you can save a couple $100. Go to communitygogiver.com. So communitygogiver.com is where you can check out the ticket pricing there. Like I said, we have early bird pricing already going on, save a couple $100, but we have some full details coming out pretty soon. We've got the lineup that we're getting put together, and we're very excited about that. Some people returning from last year. Jeffrey Taylor's returning from last year, so I'm super excited about that, and a couple other people. We're not going to give the full details just yet, so you guys got to stick around. But those are coming out pretty soon, so be on the lookout for that, and we're excited about that. So without further ado, Tom, let's get into this thing and talk about financial freedom. There's a lot that can keep people from financial freedom, and real estate is one of those ways that you can actually achieve that, and specifically through passive real estate investing. I believe so. We talk about in chapter, or page 2 is chapter 1 of your book, is financial freedom, and that's what it talks about. So what is keeping people from financial freedom? What in the world?
Well, this is just a thought that hit me this week. And so this is a fresh idea for me, at least. Fresh. Now, I'm sure there's been other people that have come up with these ideas and other people have said this. But for me, I was like, I was looking at my own personal finances and how much money I spend on certain things. And one of the things that you even can attest that in our leadership meeting for the yearly, one of the personal things I want to start doing in my own personal life is being a little bit more careful about like frivolous things that I spend money on myself. So I started looking at this, and then I started looking at I looked at my own Starbucks bill. So I was looking at how, because I can track everything that I buy on Starbucks because I use the phone app. So I can go back and look at every single time I got Starbucks. And I was looking at things, and I was like, I was probably spending close to $50 a week at Starbucks. And I said, oh my goodness, like, you know, what other things that...
So you're only buying coffee once a week or something?
Once a day. So basically, I went back and I started thinking about this. Starbucks. If I were to just go to Starbucks once a day for 5 days a week, so I was probably going more than once a day on average and probably more than 5 days a week, but I just started putting some numbers on paper, and so I started thinking about this in the context of financial freedom, because a lot of times... we actually have a group called the Good Success, our Financial Freedom Good Success, or Good Success Financial Freedom. We have some little things that we post about this and what's keeping you from financial freedom. And without a doubt, like, I always get the answer, money is keeping me from financial freedom. And I think if we think about it a little deeper, sometimes it's just our own lack of discipline, and sometimes it's just our own lack of focus on achieving a certain goal is what's really keeping us. It's not really a lack of money, because so I just picked out three things. I picked out coffee, I picked out smoking cigarettes, or drinking. And I just looked at this, and if you do these, I don't think you're a bad person. I do. So it's not like something that I think that you're a horrible person if these are things that you do. But I just looked at this and how much money, just the context of how much money you're spending on these. And I think, you know, wouldn't it be sad to find out, like, when you retire, that you could have had retirement or you could have had financial freedom if you just decided to get coffee from the store and grind it yourself? Or honestly, you know what's funny? Like, Starbucks coffee is not that good. It's horrible.
I hear people say that.
If you guys understand the process in which Starbucks goes to actually double roast their coffee beans so they all have the same the same taste and the same feel. Like, it's really not good coffee. You can go to a really good local roastery, which I love fresh roasted coffee. Like, I love coffee. Mm-hmm. And so there's a place in Crown Point here where they have fresh roasted coffee where it was green yesterday and they roasted it today. Hmm. And it there's a huge difference. So anyways, if you just go and get like really good coffee, you could spend like 50 cents a pot instead of like $5 for a cup. And you know, you could save a lot of money over a year period of time.
Well, so you said you're spending $50 a week, but then in the compound effect, it talks about, okay, what does that look like in a year?
Yes.
That's so even worse.
I back this down even a little bit. I'm not even going to say $50 a week. I actually did some numbers, okay. And you can see these numbers, so you can tell the audience that I'm legit. Accurate. It's legit. So this is what I figured. If you were going to Starbucks five times a week and it was costing you $5 a day each time. Okay. So very simple math, $25 a day times 52 weeks is $1,300 a year. So then I also, I try to like think of this, a pack of cigarettes is also, and I didn't even realize this, it's like, it's over $5 a pack, almost $6 maybe. So I just did $5 and you know, the average person that smokes probably smokes about a pack a day. So I even backed that off a little bit. Maybe you don't smoke a whole pack, Maybe you don't smoke a whole pack a day, but if let's just say you smoked five packs of cigarettes a week, okay? And so and you're getting generic type, so you're only spending $5 a pack, which probably isn't really accurate. That's another same type of number. So it's about $25 a week that you're spending. And then I thought to myself, well, maybe you stop at the bar on the way home, or maybe you get a drink every once in a while. And in the same numbers, maybe you do five a week and it's $5. And I know that's kind of cheap for some and maybe more expensive for other places or whatever, but you get the point. Mm-hmm. So $25 a week in either one of those areas is $1,300. So if you only have one of those vices, which I bet you, if you're on this podcast, you probably know somebody that has all three vices spend more money than this on one of these items or two of these items.
Sure.
So just think about that. Something that nobody can really say that any of those are necessarily healthy benefits for you. I mean, most of the time when you get a little older, the doctors will even tell you to stop drinking coffee. Mm-hmm. And switch to tea or whatever. So any of those items, you could even probably make at least a small argument that too much of it's a bad thing. So they're definitely not like healthy things. It's not like going and exercising,
right,
going and, you know, drinking more water, mm-hmm, for instance. So $1,300 a year. And I'll tell you, in real estate, if you have any kind of connection at all, you can make between 10 and 12% on your money, you know, not without having to do a lot of work. So I just did the numbers on 12% because I think if you don't have a lot of money, it's easier to keep a lot, small amount of money deployed at 12%. So I just did numbers at 12%, and I know maybe you should do it at 10%, whatever. But over 30 years, so especially you guys in your 20s or your 30s, and maybe you have 30 years, over 30 years, that habit is going to cost you how much, Josh?
$313,732.49.
Yeah, so that's the power of compounding interest on just like $25 a week over 30 years with a 12% annual interest. I didn't even go crazy and do like monthly and do extra little, you know, compounding on a monthly basis. This is a yearly annual compounding basis, over $300,000. And a lot of people, if they had that much extra money, that would make a huge difference in their financial freedom.
Yeah, absolutely.
So let's just say you had two. So you had two of these vices. So and I promise you, there's people that are listening to this right now that they're spending $50 a week on a combination of two of these, mm-hmm, or just coffee like I was, or just drinking, or just some. I know people at times who have smoked three packs of cigarettes a day. I mean, it's just insane. Let's just say it was only two packs. So any of these combinations,
and people can use anything else.
And you know
too.
What? Honestly, like if you just think about it, like how often do you go out to eat?
Right. Exactly.
If you spend $25 to go out to eat four or five times a week or three times a week, and you just cut one of those,
exactly,
the numbers are the same. So exactly. So just think about it. That habit is going to cost you $300,000 in financial freedom down the road. So let's just do the example. If you have two, of these compound interest over a period of time, which I think I sure hope I did these numbers right, because I guess in my mind I was thinking it would be double, but I think it's because of the compounding interest.
Right.
It's not quite. No, it won't be double. Yeah, it should be double. I don't know. Anyways, so according to this spreadsheet, which I kind of went all the way down line by line, it's almost $600,000. So $572,000. So $500,000 if you are spending $50 a day, 5 days a week, on two of these habits. If you have all three or you're spending $75 a week, that's $850,000. So most people could retire on $85,000 to $100,000 a year. Mm-hmm. And I know that everybody couldn't, but most people could retire on that kind of money. And that's the kind of money you would have on automatic if you could just make 10 or 12% interest. If 12% interest would probably be closer to $100,000 a year on $850,000. But at 10% interest, it's $85,000. And if it's in a tax deferred or tax, you know, free account like a Roth IRA that we promote Quest because we love Quest and, right. and all my self-directed IRA stuff is in Quest. But if you just think about it in that context, like this is what, in my opinion, this is what's keeping a ton of people from financial freedom is just these little habits that they have in their life that's costing them a lot of money.
Well, like you said, it doesn't have to just be coffee or cigarettes or alcohol. Like it could be going to the movies.
Yep.
It could be, like you said, going out to eat. I mean, you could go out to eat one time a week and spend $25, spend that yep. amount. So it's your, right. your own, like your scope.
Could I, or in the larger context, could I spend $1,300 less every year on a car? Could I spend $1,300 sure. less a year on my vacation?
Yeah.
You know, so this isn't a self-directed IRA, you know, podcast, but to me, it's about financial freedom. This is sure. just self-directed IRA is just part of the equation that I think you ought to.
But that's just three about. Items that you added up, and that's $858,000.
That's $75 a week.
That's guys, it's almost a million. Jeez.
Yep. If you did this in $100 a week, it'd be over $1 million.
Sure.
So if you could save $100 a week, you would end up with over $1 million over a 30-year period of time if you're investing it.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
So financial freedom, what is it? What is it to you? I think so that's kind of like just my introduction, mm-hmm. but you know, in my opinion, everybody needs to know what financial freedom means to them. So many times we don't reach our goals because we're just not willing to verbalize and we're not willing to want what we want to want. We have to say, this is what I want. Be very clear about it. What does financial freedom mean to you? What does that mean as far as from a financial number? So, you know, if you go to any kind of financial freedom guru or any conference, they're only going to say, find out what your number is. Mm-hmm. So that's the very first thing, is to find out what your number is. To me, and everybody's idea is a little different. So my idea on what your financial number is what do you need annually? So what's your annual amount that you need to live on? You know, so if you had this amount coming in automatically every single year, like you wouldn't need to have to worry about your bills, your actual living, you know, and anything that you want to do on a normal yearly basis. I would figure that out first. So to me, I would write it all down. I wouldn't start with your budget. I would start with, what do I want to spend my money on? If I could spend my money on purpose, what would I want to spend my money on? So that means you are going to need some things. So some of these things are needs. Some of these things are wants. Some of these things are just, you know, things that you want to put in your life, or things that you want to give. You know, so for me, my first number is always tithe, which you don't really know what that tithe is until you figure out and giving to the church is you don't know what that is until you know what the top number is. But to me, that's my first number I put on there. But second of all, like, what else do I want to give to people? A mortgage payment. And if you think about this in a long period of time, you may not have a mortgage. You might have your house paid off if you're older and you've been in the house for a long time. But a mortgage, car payment, if you need a car payment, maybe you can have it paid off in cash. Mm-hmm. But figure out what that is. For most people, it's somewhere between $5,000 to $12,000 a month. Like, that's for most people, like, that's what their number ends up being. And I know that you can do it for less. I know you can, and I know some people that, like, their number is $20,000, but for most people, that's somewhere between $6,000 and $12,000 a month. So what I would do is I would write down every single month everything that might come up. So your vacations, what about Christmas? You know, sometimes we forget about budgeting Christmas into our financial freedom plan or into our number. If you want to continue investing, or if you want to continue putting more money towards investment, maybe it's only $1,300 a year, maybe it's $5,000 a year, maybe it's $20,000 a year. Budget that into that financial freedom plan, because at the end of the day, you want to leave a legacy. You want to leave more if you possibly can. So figure out what that is. What is your number? And then after you figured out what your number is, I think one of the most important parts about financial freedom is, why do you want it? Because the why of financial freedom is what will keep you going. It'll keep you disciplined towards that goal, because every day you'll wake up and be like, oh, maybe I want to go get coffee. But then you're like, oh, maybe I really want to have financial freedom because I want this. You know, and it's different for every single person. For some people, it's just security. Some people are like, I just want to have the security to know that I'm taken care of, or my family's taken care of, or that it's security is one of those emotional ties. And you want to make it emotional. You want to make that why emotional, because that will keep you going. So some of it's freedom of time. Sometimes people just want to have more freedom. They don't want to have to work a job, which I'm not that type of person. Like, to me, I always want to work. I always want to have something that I'm doing that I am. I'm purposely working and producing something with my time. Mm-hmm. But I also want to have more freedom, you know, in some point in my life with that time and have more freedom of time. Helping others. I mean, for me, like, I want to have financial freedom now in my life so I can go out and I can help others, or I can have a bigger impact or create a bigger movement or whatever the case is. It's all about, like, kind of, I have this moat, and as soon as my moat's taken care of, then I can go out and slay the dragon. You mm-hmm. know, like, if you think about it in that aspect. Some people want to have financial freedom because it'll help them fulfill their purpose. You know, maybe I know people that want to become financially free so that way they can spend the rest of their life maybe doing missions work or doing work for other people. I know dentists, for instance, that are financially free in their dental practice, and now they go and do 5 or 6 dental tours in third world countries and help people with their teeth in other countries for free. And they love that. They love being able to have that purpose. And, you know, sometimes it's just people that you might think, the reason why I want to do this is because I want to do my bucket list, or I want to help my family with their bucket list. I want to take them to Disney World or Australia or go do all these things. And you know, whatever it is, like, all these things, every reason, I'll tell you, almost every person is going to have at least some of all of these. So figure out why you want to have financial freedom. You know, and some people, obviously, I think legacy has to be brought into the equation as well, why I would want to have financial freedom. All those things are great reasons, and I think that you got to figure out why for you. So why for me? I already told you, it's so I can give more, so I can be able to be a better conduit, so I can, I mean, anything you make over a certain point, I can give a higher percentage of that away. And I believe in living life that way. Living frugally and giving generously is one of the disciplines that I believe in order to have good success that you have to have. So after you figured out, you know, after you've done what you want, why you want it, in my opinion, the next step of this process is to kind of come back to where you at now. So this is where you create your budget. This is where you go. And, you know, if you've ever been to, you know, a David Ramsey course, mm-hmm. what is he going to say? Like, what are you spending right now? Figure out what you're spending now. So kind of like, you got to figure out where you're at now in order to figure out how to get to where you want to go. Right. So like, if you're going to climb a mountain, you always like figure out that point first where you want to get to.
Right.
Okay. And then you might second guess yourself and be like, why do I want to go up there again? You know, say, and then you chart that course and you kind of work your way backwards in your head, but you got to start with where you're at now. You mm-hmm. can't start from a different point. You can't be, sometimes this is a hard part for people because people don't want to be honest with themselves. They don't want to realize I'm in this much debt. They don't want to realize, ooh, I'm spending $50 a week on coffee. Shame on you.
They want to avoid that.
They want to avoid that, like being honest with themselves about themselves. So I think you have to go back to that point of where are you really now? How much money are you really spending? It's kind of like a process, you know, like mm-hmm. what's as is process and what's the improvement process? It's like same thing. Like, what am I doing now? What is the reality for right now? What am I spending all my money on? And then create a budget for what you think you should create, how much money you should be spending. That's kind of like part of the next point. So part of the next point is how. So once I've gone to that point where I said, I want financial freedom, this is my number. And then I've kind of come back a little bit and said, this is why I want to reach that. Then I come back and I'm like, where am I at now? And then I start creating that plan. That plan starts with my budget. How much money do I need to spend now? And that plan also is going to include my investments. How much money am I going to be disciplined to put aside every single week or every single month that I'm going to make this plan happen? Now, some people might already have part of this in motion. You know, a lot of people have 401ks. They have money that they can already start deploying. So part of your plan, like, people are in different parts of this plan already today. You got to figure out where you're at. Are you at the very beginning where I don't know nothing. I don't know anything about financial freedom, and I need some people just need knowledge. They need connections. They need to kind of know how to go about setting up a self-directed IRA account or setting up an IRA or stacking money away or creating that process to be able to create financial freedom for themselves. Maybe you need a budget. Maybe you need an accountability partner who's going to actually, you know, ask you every single month, hey, did you put this away? Maybe you need to set up automatic payments, you know? So a lot of times if you'll just set up those automatic payments, you'll automate that process for you, and the money that you like take out automatically every single month is something that people need. So after you figured out where you're at now, you have to figure out how you're going to get there. So, you know, and you may pick the wrong path at some point. You might go up this mountain this way and then realize, holy crap, I got to come back down and go back up around there because it's not going to work. But you need to create the plan that's going to work for you. For me, my financial freedom plan includes three things: owning businesses and that the businesses pay. You know me, I do love business. Even though I love real estate, I probably love business, the actual, you know, thought of business more than I even like real estate. But real estate is a big part of my financial freedom plan. So I have business, real estate, and lending. Those are like my three, you know, things that I think that's my plan. But that doesn't mean that has to be your plan. You may be all business. You may be all real estate. You may be all lending. You might have funds that you invest in. You may be invest in the stock market. You may have, you know, gold or other things that you think is the right for you. But you got to come up with your own plan and how you are going to reach financial freedom. That is the next step. I think after you figured out how you're going to get there and you've come up with that plan, then you have to figure out when. Like, now it's time to like say, when am I going to hit that peak of that mountain? How am I going to hit financial freedom? I've already figured that out, but when am I going to have it by? If you don't give yourself a time, time is like a suitcase. You know, if I give an employee 8 hours to get a task done, I bet you most employees are going to take 8 hours to get that task done. But if I give the same employee 4 hours to get the same task done, he's going to be a whole lot closer to getting that task done in 4 hours, or he's going to have it done in 4 hours. Like, you'll get done as much as you give yourself time for. I believe most people can become financially free somewhere between 5 and 10 years. And I don't care how old you are. I really don't. Like, I know how much money you make. I mean, I just showed you how you could set yourself on course when you're in your 20s with $25 a week. But most people that really start focusing on this can be financially free 5 to 10 years. Most people, and I've seen, and honestly, for me, I set a goal for 5 years and reached it in 3, because what you'll find out is when you start implementing, you'll see other things that you didn't know before, and you'll have new connections that you didn't know before. And it's just like a snowball effect. It ends up going faster than you think. So when are you going to reach financial freedom? Is that like, hold yourself to a date. Like, this is when I will have financial freedom. And then after you figure all that out, you have to go back and be like, okay, well, what do I need to do right now? So, you know, after you figured out what you want, why you want it, when you're going to have, how you're going to get there, or sorry, where you're at now, how you're going to get there, you know, when you're going to have it by, then say, what do I need to do right now? So what you need to do right now might need to be, you know, actually write down what are your next steps. What do you need to do? Maybe you need to review these steps. Maybe you need to kind of go back and be like, I need to write down what financial freedom means for me. I might need to go back and say, you know, what am I spending money on right now that I shouldn't be spending money on? What do I need to cut out of my budget? Maybe I don't have enough income. Maybe really like I need to have a side hustle, or maybe I need to figure out somewhere where I don't need this money, but if I were to make an extra $200 a month, maybe I could set 100% of that aside for financial freedom. Maybe I need more knowledge, so maybe I need to go read some books, or maybe I need to connect with people that can teach me something. Maybe I need to go to some financial freedom seminars or connect with people that have financial freedom. Maybe I need connections or network. You know, maybe I need a mentor, and there are a lot of great mentors out there that will teach financial freedom. Maybe I need an accountability partner. Maybe I need a budget. You know, whatever it is for you, wherever you're at in this, write down what your next steps are. What do you need in order to hit that goal? And you know, who, maybe you need help with something. You know, so write down who it is that if you connect with this person, maybe they'll help you. Maybe you need a process. Maybe you need automation. Whatever that is, write down what those next steps are. Maybe you just need to know more about investing as well. So like, maybe you have some money and you're a little farther down this path, but you need to be able to have investments that you can invest in that you feel are safe and you feel are not like gambling at the casino, which I believe most of the stock market is today. And I'm not saying that I'm 100% against it, but I think there's a lot of the stock market investing, a lot of Bitcoin, a lot of stuff like that is honestly just gambling. So just to kind of review, like, what do you want? Be very clear about it. Why do you want it? Where are you at now? How are you going to get there? What's that plan? When are you going to have financial freedom? So give yourself that date and then ask yourself those questions. Ask yourself what it is that you need to do right now. And then the most important step. So you can do all of that and still fail. You can do all that and never have financial freedom. And I bet you there's a lot of people out there that are listening right now that have done those steps and they've never done this next step. This next step will do like, it's like what you've, all of that stuff we just talked about is the 1%. This next step is literally the 99% of all this, and that is act. I mean, simply action changes things. ACT, action changes things. If you don't act, if you don't actually implement, if you don't actually call the person you need, if you don't actually make the investments, if you don't actually stop spending the money that you shouldn't be spending, if you don't act, you're never going to get anywhere in life. And you know, what's sad to me, Josh, is there's so many people that I see that have great ideas. They're brilliant. They're smart. They have connection. They have all the stuff. They just don't do anything. They don't act on it. And that's the biggest, that's one of the biggest things that like I don't understand myself. I'm the type of person that will act before I even know, and I'll just figure it out, or I'll figure out how to figure it out in the middle of figuring it out if I have to. So act. And really, that's it. Like, you've got to continually improve. So every single year, maybe sit down and reset this and kind of be like, where am I at again? Where am I at this year? Where am I going to go this year? And make these lists of the things that you need that next year. So maybe in the first year might be different. Maybe you have money in a 401k. You need to roll it over. You know, maybe you need to start saving some more money. Maybe you need to make more money. Whatever it is, like, in that process, you can do it. I believe everybody in America can be financially free if they'll just focus on it. And I think focus is definitely key when it comes to financial freedom.
Yeah. So I got a couple follow-up questions here and then we'll wrap it up. Some incredible stuff. So the first thing is just to follow up that last point that you had, and something interesting that Scott Carson said on our podcast is the only guarantee to fail is not acting. So yep. Like, that's the only way that you are absolutely 100% guaranteed to fail is by not taking action. You can take action and still fail, but it's not guaranteed that you're going to fail. So I love that. That's the perfect way to cap it off. And I completely agree with you.
Yeah, but you know what? If you take action and you fail, I don't really think that you're a failure.
Sure.
Until you quit, until you give up, until you stop trying, until you stop getting better. Mm-hmm. And I think that's the difference between most successful people and non-successful people, is because non-successful people give up. They just, and they really become failures because of what they feed their mind, and they don't believe that they can actually achieve it because they just stop. You will be shocked. I mean, to me, I'm telling you from my own personal life, I saw this in my own personal life when I went through this financial freedom journey myself, and I did exactly what I'm telling you guys to do. This isn't rocket science. This is just what I did, and this is how I believe. Actually, if you look at the outline of what I've outlined of what, why, where, how, where am I at now, you know, ask yourself the questions, write your plan out, and then act. Like, that's a project management tool of any kind. If you ever want to achieve anything in life, like, that is the way you're going to do it. But what will stop everybody is acting, or if they act and then, oh, it didn't work out, like, it's perfectly the way I thought it was going to work out, and then they give up.
Something along the lines of the difference between successful people and unsuccessful people is, and we've talked about this a couple times on the show, is that successful people think long-term, unsuccessful people think short-term. With this plan, if you have short-term thinking, if you're going into this thinking that it's going to happen like next year, then this isn't for you.
Yeah, let's just look at these numbers, Josh. So after year two, what do you have? How much money do you have?
$2,756.
Most people can't get through year five.
Sure.
And this is only $1,300 a year, guys.
Right.
So I would bet most people can save more than $1,300 or invest more than $1,300 a year. Mm-hmm. But let's just say you can invest $3,900, you don't really see anything significant until after year five, year six, year seven. You know, and that's a really small dollar amount. Mm-hmm. If you just fully funded your self-directed IRA, which is $5,500. If you just fully funded your self-directed IRA after year seven, you're looking at $46,000. And if you just did that for 30 years, how much you got?
$1.2 million.
$1.2 million with 30 years, $5,500.
$5,500. You're a millionaire.
Yeah, seriously.
But that's long-term thinking.
Yes.
And that's, do you think that's one of the biggest key reasons why people fail at this? Because they want to get their coffee now. Because yep. they want to get their Absolutely. Alcohol. Because they want to go to the movies twice
it's
a week.
It's all about how I feel now.
Yes, absolutely. And that's what most products, I mean, studying marketing and sales even, like that's one of the things is the feeling. That's people love the feeling of immediate satisfaction. And that's incredible. So yeah,
it's sad.
It's very sad. It is extremely sad. And that's one of the things I wrote down here was short-term versus long-term thinking. Another thing that I like, I love how you structured so the what, why, where, when, and then act. I heard a podcast the other day about habits and how people set goals. So goals are, you have to have goals. Like you said, that's a non-negotiable, but a lot of times, you know, people have the exact same goals, but one person will reach it. Another person won't. And the question is why? And the guy that was on the podcast, I can't think of his name for the life of me right now, but he said the reason why the person that failed is because they didn't plan and systematize properly. So the person that reached their goals planned the best. They practiced the most. So let's say sports, right? So one of the ultimate goals is to win a championship in sports, right? Like that's the pinnacle for any sport that you're looking at. And the team that wins the championship practiced the hardest. They played the hardest during the game. They were, you know, showed up early to practice. They did whatever. They watched game film, all that stuff. They planned the best. They systematized the best. And that's typically the person that reached their goal. So what are your thoughts on that? I know that you talked about, so you did what, why, where, when, and then act. So obviously act is, there's like three things, the goal, the systems, and then the acting.
Mm-hmm. So you're talking about how to get there.
And, specifically, yes. Right, so, and that's what most people fail. That's what it seems like, because anybody can set high goals. But that's not I don't feel like that's the exact answer for.
See, I guess I just don't. To me, I don't believe that. I don't believe the reason why they didn't is because of the how. I believe it really is because of the why. Because in my opinion, mm-hmm. if the why is big enough, the what will take care of itself. And that's why I think that why has to be in the equation way before you figure out how. I know Simon Sinek says start with why. I think you ought to start with what, because you don't really know. If you don't know what you're doing, I don't think you can figure out why.
Right.
Sure. So so that's why I think it's what first and then why. But I think you have to have that. The why is what has to drive you. Sure. And if you're not, and if your why is not big enough, then, and if you don't believe in that why, and if you don't focus on that why, you're not going to systematize. You're not going to make mm-hmm. it better. You're just going to like be
well,
okay.
I'm not saying
with
starting with
quo.
Systematizing.
No,
and
I'm
planning.
Just saying
it's like,
I think that's the reason why people don't figure out how. You know, like basically what you're saying is the reason why people fail is because they don't figure out how. And I'm saying, well, they don't figure out how because they didn't really give themselves a why that was big enough that mattered enough to them to make it happen.
So you're saying the why is the driver.
It is the grit. It is mm-hmm. it is the reason why you grind. It is the, you know, like who's the 10X guy?
Grant Cardone.
Grant Cardone is like, you've got to hustle. You've got to whatever he calls it. I don't know. But there are a lot of people that's what they talk about, the grind. And like there are because there are times where you're not going to want to do this. There's
but
there's times that you're not going to want to be committed. There's times you're not going to want to be disciplined. And normally, in my opinion, discipline equals freedom. And we think of it opposite. We think, well, freedom means I can do whatever I want, whenever I want, with whoever I want. I don't think that's freedom at all. Freedom is in the obeying the rules. Freedom is in being disciplined. Freedom is in doing the right thing that you're supposed to do, even though it's hard. For me, I believe that's what financial freedom looks like in money. So it's about being disciplined. It's the actual discipline of the process that gives you freedom.
But that's what I'm saying. That's inside of the systematizing and the planning is like you have to be disciplined in that. But I love so it's what and then why am I doing this what and then how do I do this like what? So yep. that's cool. Very and then acting obviously. So that's a big part of this. Okay. Well, cool. I think that's. I didn't have a lot of questions. You explained everything pretty well. I mean, it's very simple. It's when you look at it this way. Again, it's long-term thinking. That's what it comes down to with the mindset is, you know, of course, being disciplined, but long-term thinking versus short-term thinking. Because so many people, like the majority of people, think short-term. They love the feeling right now. And if you're that type of person, you have to grow out of that. And you're never going to reach this if you do that. So,
so if I had to leave the audience with one thing, the one thing I would leave the audience with is do something now. Just do it today. Don't hesitate. Don't delay. Like, I don't care. You're probably in one of these steps. You're probably somewhere in this realm. I mean, they say, I think only 3 to 5% of people ever really become to this point where they're really financially free, which I think is really sad. But because I think it's available to every single at least people in the United States.
Absolutely.
But like, do something today. If you don't get anything else from this podcast, do something today towards that goal. I used to have a pastor, I used to love it. He used to say, if I was on my way from New York to California and my car broke down, I would still get out every day and push my car 10 feet just to know I was a little bit closer to my goal every single day. So do something today. Don't delay and just make it happen.
It starts with right now, and a lot of people procrastinate because they don't want it. They don't want that feeling right now. They don't want that you know, the exercise feeling where it hurts now, but then it's going to feel good later.
This is something, if you wait for 2 weeks, it's not going to happen.
Yeah.
Like, you have to make some kind of conscious decision to change to something today. Do something today.
So we want you guys to act right now. So jump off this podcast, go figure out what, why, where, when, and then act on it. Financial freedom. This is what's keeping most people from financial freedom. So we appreciate you sharing that with us, Tom.
Awesome.
And this is like Tom said, this is how he's achieved it. I remember recording a video with you. What was this, like 2 or 3 years ago or something, about Tom becoming financial free at the age of 40 years old, which is absolutely incredible. I mean, most people dream about that and don't even come close to it. So I think that's awesome. This is how Tom did it, and it's working. Like, I'm currently doing it right now, and it's working very well for me. But again, it's that long-term thinking and then acting, figuring out what, figuring out why, figuring out where, figuring out when, and then act on it. So you guys, jump off the podcast and go act. Do it.
Tell us what you're going to do. I'd
love to
hear.
Yes. That Facebook group. So just go to the Good Success page, and then somewhere on there, I believe on the mobile app and the desktop, you can find that the groups that we have going on right now. And there's two groups, which is just Good Success and then Good Success Financial Freedom, which Good Success Financial Freedom is specifically geared towards this type of content. Go on there, join up on that, and we would love to hear what you guys are doing for this. So that's going to do it for today's episode, guys, unless you have anything else to share, Tom.
No.
This is a lot of information. People got to do something about it. But that is it. So if you guys have not already, make sure you have joined subscribe, not joined. I'm saying join the Facebook group. So join that. But maybe we'll put a special link so they can go to goodsuccess.com/financialfreedom or something like that. So Emily, if we could take notes on that. Subscribe to the Good Success Podcast. We're on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Stitcher, Google Play, all the podcast platforms. Just search us there and you'll find us. If you can, leave a review. We would appreciate if you did that. I know Apple Podcasts might be one of the only ones that allows you to leave reviews. Leave a review for us. We'd love to hear your thoughts on this. And then the Active Turnkey Book, The Best Way to Buy Rentals. Tom talked about three of his ways of achieving financial freedom is business, is real estate, and lending. And I think, so this is specifically real estate, but lending's involved in this too.
Absolutely.
So there's a couple of things right there. So this talks about that. And the very first chapter is financial freedom. Mm-hmm. And so this is the Active Turnkey Book, Best Way to Buy Rentals. And Tom has signed all of these, this whole stack here. I think I only got like 4 or 5, but we're going to have
4 or 5 left.
We're going to have to sign a couple more, I think. But these are running out. As soon as I run out of stock on these, then you got to buy it from
then
Amazon.
We should start making people pay for them.
We should, yeah, absolutely. Because yeah. they're free right now.
If they can buy a rocket ship,
they pay for shipping and handling on this. They get this book for free, and then they trade it for a spaceship.
A spaceship, yes.
That's the process there.
I can't wait.
We talked about taking action right now.
That's awesome. Take action right now and order your free book.
GoodSuccess.com.
That might be the step that you need to take.
Exactly. I mean, what you could trade it for a spaceship? Like, that's financial freedom right there.
Yeah,
I think goodsuccess.com/ATK book is where you can pick that up. So make sure you take advantage of that. A lot of great content in here. Tom did sign all these books. So if you order that right now, then you are going to get a signed copy of the Active Turnkey book. So make sure you take advantage of that. One more time, goodsuccess.com/ATK book. And then we have the Good Success Mastermind. Another couple of weeks is the November event in Miami, Florida, November 8, 9, and 10. It's not too late to sign up. So go to goodsuccess.com/mastermind and fill out the application there. You'll talk to either myself or Tom. Our first quarter event right now is February 6, 7, and 8. And that is in Dallas, Texas at Quest IRA's office in Dallas, Texas. So we're very excited about that. We might be bumping that to a week, so stay tuned for full details, but you can apply for that again one more time, goodsuccess.com/mastermind. To learn more about it, you'll talk to either myself or Tom. And then the Community Go Giver event, early bird pricing is going on right now. The 2019 event is June 26, 27, and 28. So save a couple $100, go to communitygogiver.com and you can purchase the tickets there. That's going to do it for today's episode. We appreciate you jumping on and joining us and learning more about what's keeping you from financial freedom. If you've listened all the way through this, like, you're not acting yet. So nope. As soon as this podcast is up, act. Go do something about it. Thank you guys for joining us. And remember to be a conduit and not a bucket.
Work to have to give. And Josh, we are going to a week in February. It's going to happen, dude.
1 week in February.
Dude, it's going to happen.
I think it's February.
You just got to believe.
February 3rd through the 8th.
Dude, we're going to make this happen.
We're going to make it happen.
We will make it happen.
Thank you for joining us. We'll catch you in the next one. Thank you so much for listening to this Good Success Podcast episode. Make sure to subscribe to us. We're on iTunes, Google Play, Stitcher, Anchor, or Spotify, any one of those platforms, however you like to listen to your podcast. Make sure you subscribe. And just a quick reminder to go pick up your free copy of the Active Turnkey book. It's absolutely free. Just cover the shipping costs and we'll pay for the book. Just head over to goodsuccess.com/ATK book. Again, that's goodsuccess.com/ATK book. And you can pick up the book there. So make sure you go do that. Thank you for listening. And remember to be a conduit, not a bucket.